This may look like another regular suburban street, but behind these walls is the emergency room of Dunedin's very own Kereru Hospital.
A lady's ring this morning. It's a little bit stressed, I think.
Did it hit the window?
Well, it fell in through her garage and up into the inside.
Why would it fly into the garage?
Possibly because it was flying under the influence of alcohol.
What would it have been drinking?
They don't necessarily drink the alcohol, but they eat fermented plums, especially if you know the plums have been on the trees in really, really hot weather, and then they eat them and then...
And they get a little bit disoriented.
Yes.
What do they eat?
In the aviary, I've got trees that they would eat in the wild, but we also feed them supplementary food, peas, plums, peaches, chickpeas.
Well, should we go and take a look at your other birds in the aviary?
Okay.
All right. Feeding time. How did it all start for you? How did you become the nurse of the Kereru Hospital?
Kind of happened by accident, really. When I first started vet nursing, I used to look after the birds in the clinic, and I kept working with these guys.
So have you always had a setup like this for the Kereru?
No. For a long, long time, it was at home and in Mum and Dad's house, in the garden shed. I was having to keep them confined because they'd have broken wings and broken bones, and then they were losing muscle condition, and they could, when it came time to release them, they could hardly fly, and it just got to the point where I really needed an aviary. So I decided to ask for help, and this is what we've got now.
Did you know that Kereru almost have a flip-top head so they can swallow the larger fruits and berries whole, which would be the equivalent of me swallowing a whole grapefruit? If I found an injured Kereru in my backyard, what should I do?
Best thing you can do, carefully pick it up with a towel or a sheet, put it in a box and keep it somewhere warm, dark and quiet, and then call Department of Conservation. Stress is one of the biggest killers of birds.
Oh, you're little.
Still got a bit of down.
You're very little.
It's small, isn't it?
It's tiny.
It's just young, and it was found walking on the main road near the cemetery.
Do you think 10, 20 years from now you'll have the whole thing with doctors and nurses running everywhere?
Don't know. Watch this space.
Kereru rehab is a tough process, which involves a good diet, plenty of exercise, and for some, a little bit of drying out. That's why Nick's role here as Chief Kereru Nurse is crucial in getting these big, beautiful birds back in the air.